Today we start a little mini series. Let's talk step for revival in all its four programs. And today we're starting with the most important step, I think. But another steps is so good too. Don't miss that the coming days here, because it's encourage you to really move on and go stronger with the Lord, all the good things He has for you, and to lead you out to what is to reach people around you. And today we will be talking over the subject proclaim the Christ Jesus. That is very fundamental to all preaching and teaching, is to really proclaim His name, because that is in His name. It's the power, there is the anointing, there is what, you know, the making the difference to not only speaking a good talk, but to really to see the power of God moving. And that is a secret to reach in to people and to change, to see a change in people's life. It's only through His name that are releasing the power and anointing of God. Praise God. You know, it's so important to understand step for revival. You know, many times we be praying and praying and praying to God, oh, send your revival, send a revival to us, let change this place and do this and do this. But you know, when revival comes, it's when some people start to proclaim the name of Jesus. When someone is doing something, you know, God don't send angels to start a revival. They are, of course, involved, but it is not coming suddenly an angel on the street and standing there and start to preach. But what is really happening, that is He's using you and me to share the gospel with people. In Acts chapter 8, we can read about the disciples and all the followers in the first church. And the church was growing and growing and growing there in Jerusalem. But when we come to chapter 6 and 7 and 8, there was a change. And people could not stay in Jerusalem because the hate and the situation was so hard for the believers to stay there, because the Roman soldiers and the religion leaders was against them and tried to destroy the church. But you know, they went out to the whole country, and it's written that everywhere they come. In chapter 8, everywhere they come, these people from the church in Jerusalem, everyone, wherever they come, they're preaching the kingdom. They're preaching about Jesus. Hallelujah. So they was not down. They was not thinking, okay, they was not working, so let us forget these things. And there was so much persecution, and there was so much hard time, and people was killed and so on. We run away from this and hide somewhere. I can keep this faith on Jesus for me as a private thing. You know, that's a very Scandinavian way to think. You know, faith in Jesus, that is very private. And you keep that for yourself. And don't push your children, don't push anyone, Jesus. Keep it for yourself. That is for yourself's good. You know, the Bible says, go out to all the world and preach the word. Hallelujah. and make disciples of everyone that you can get. So don't keep it private. Don't keep it for yourself. You need to share your experience with somebody else. And Philip, we can read about him in Acts chapter 8 and verse 5. He went down to a city in Samaria. So, and he was one of the helpers in the church, in helping to serve. He was pointed out to really leading the help work in the church. But now he had left Jerusalem and he come to a city in Samaria. And what was he doing? You think he come there? Oh, this is a nice city in Samaria. This is a good place to hide and keep my Jesus for myself. No. Philip comes there in Samaria. He go in, and what he's doing, he proclaimed the Christ Jesus there. When the crowd hear Philip and saw the miracle signs he did, they all paid close attention to what he said. With scribes, evil spirits comes out of many, and many paralytics and cripples was healed. So there was a great joy in the city. Hallelujah. The result when he proclaimed the name of Jesus was not that people get angry on him. No, they start to happen miracles. They start to happen things that so people start to listen to what he has to say, and the whole city get happy and grateful. This is happen when you not keep your faith for yourself. When you start to share your faith, you share the joy and happiness that you have received in your heart, that will you share with another people. And I know one guy, when he gets saved, and he was 50 plus when he gets saved, and when he gets saved, his first response, you know what it was? What have no one tell me this before? This joy, I cannot explain it, but I should have, what if I have that all another 50 years I have lived too? That has felt much better and make life so much easier. But I'm so happy I have received it now. And he is out, he preaching, he sharing, because the joy he have received, he need to share it with somebody else. Hallelujah. There was a great joy in the city. Hallelujah. And Paul, he have experienced the same thing. In the 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 2, say, he says like this: for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and with much trembling. My message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with a demonstration of the Spirit's power. Hallelujah. You know, that is the, you know, what he says, accept Jesus Christ. Amen. That's the most, to proclaim his name. That is releasing the power of the Spirit and the demonstration of the power of God. Amen. And in the 1 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 20, Paul says again, for the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's not how much you can talk, how much good thing you know. It's the power of God that make a difference. And it's so important that we keep to that. Proclaim Jesus wherever you go. Proclaim his name. Don't be ashamed. Stand up for him and make a difference wherever you come. Be wise, but on the same time, don't be ashamed and don't keep it in your secret. You need to shout it out. And when you shout it out his name, you will see the revival come. Not all your prayers. It's good you burn it in prayer, but you need to move and doing things too, and to start to proclaim the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. I pray for everyone that they will be encouraged to really move on in your power and in your anointing in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.